Alright guys, a normal Lm2596 IC buck converters gets hot basically when we draw more than 2 amps. But these modules are designed to handle up to 3 amps. But if you draw continuously 3 amps, you may blow up the IC and also the small inductor unless we use a heatsink on it. So in this video, I am going to make a few changes by adding a small heatsink with a cooling fan and the small voltmeter, which almost looks like an adjustable power supply. So let's get started. So before making this done, you need to remove the double-sided PCB on the other side of this buck converter, because these two positive and negative terminals get shorted when we connect directly on the heatsink. And if you look closer, there are some small dots on this PCB, and these are the main connection from the other side of this board. So I started removing the double-sided PCB by using a small piece of blade, but only the positive terminal. And I also removed the upper layer of this board, so as you can see, the whole body is negative. Then I made a few holes on the heatsink to fix the circuit on it and make sure whether the preset is not touching the heatsink. After adding a thermal paste and connecting both together, I used some screws to fix tightly on the heatsink. Then I installed a small cooling fan below the heatsink so it cools down the heatsink when the circuit gets hot, and a small voltmeter beside the buck converter. Then I used a 7812 regulated IC. It gives the constant 12 volt to the cooling fan and as well as to power the small voltage display. The measuring wire will be connected to the output of this board. Before that, I connected a 5A22 Schottky diode at the output. It protects the circuit from the reverse polarity, and a small DC socket at the input. After soldering everything, I used these pieces of acrylic sheets to cover the whole circuit, and I already made a few holes for the input and output. So I used a bonded tight glue which almost worked like an epoxy to connect each of these acrylic sheets on the heatsink. I connected them all together on the heatsink to cover the whole circuit. And I used a normal glue at the top, because if in case the circuit blow up, unfortunately we can still replace it by opening the top. Now we need to connect the potentiometer knob to the preset to the adjustment of the output voltage, but as you can see, it doesn't fit directly on the preset, so you need a small gear like this which can fit on both sides. Then I used these small pieces of rubber tubes as a stand, and it mainly used it to allow the air to flow through the CPU fan and also the small heatsink. And now it's time to test it, so I connected to a computer power supply which can produce 20 amps maximum. Before that, I was using a laptop charger, but it is connecting the power to the load if you draw more than 2 amps. So I started increasing the output voltage by rotating the potentiometer, and it nearly came to 3 amps. But as you can see, whenever I want to draw more than 3 amps, it suddenly dropped around 2 amps, because this IC is only designed to handle up to 3 amps of its peak level. And if you still continue when the current is dropped, you may blow up the IC even using a heatsink. Either than that, it works perfect with a 3 amps load, and the heatsink doesn't even get warm after a 1 hour of test. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.